Good morning to the students of class 5. Students, in the last class, we have begun with the topic measuring temperature. Now, what is temperature? Just recall. Temperature is a measure of the degree of hotness or coldness of an object. And the temperature of something tells us how hot or cold something is. As for example, students, during the summer season, you feel hot and during the winter season, you feel cold. So why does this happen? This happens because during the summer, the temperature of the atmosphere is high. And during the winter season, the temperature of the atmosphere is low. That is why in summer, you feel hot and in winter, you feel cold. That is why you wear the woolen clothes in order to protect yourself from the cold. Now students, you have studied in the last class the different scales for measuring temperature. So the three scales of measurement of temperature are degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit and Kelvin. On the Celsius scale, the freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius, whereas its boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. So, this scale is calibrate from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. On the Fahrenheit scale, the freezing point of water is 32 degree Fahrenheit, whereas its boiling point is 212 degree Fahrenheit. So, this scale is calibrate from 32 degree Fahrenheit to 212 degree Fahrenheit. And the formula used for conversion of the temperature from Celsius scale to Fahrenheit scale is degree Fahrenheit equals to degree Celsius into 9 by 5 plus 32. Students, in the last class, we have studied that thermometer is the tool which is used for measuring temperature. Now, we are going to study about the clinical thermometer. Now, what is a clinical thermometer? The thermometer that measures the temperature of our body is called the clinical thermometer. And this type of thermometer is used by the doctors and nurses in hospitals in order to measure or take the body temperature of the patients. So, in a clinical thermometer, it consists of a bulb at one of its end. Then it has a bore inside it, which is filled with a liquid metal called mercury. And you have the readings on the glass, which is outside. So, here the temperatures of the water freezing point and boiling point are given in both Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale. So, in Celsius scale, the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius and the freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius. And in Fahrenheit scale, the boiling point of water is 212 degree Fahrenheit and the freezing point of water is 32 degree Fahrenheit. Alright, so keep this temperature in your mind. You will have to learn up these temperatures. So, you can say that water freezes at 0 degree Celsius or 32 degree Fahrenheit and water boils at 100 degree Celsius or 212 degree Fahrenheit. And the normal body temperature of human being is 37 degree Celsius or 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Next, you have a formula given for conversion of the temperature from Celsius scale to Fahrenheit scale. So, for converting the temperature from Celsius scale to Fahrenheit scale, what you will do? You will write F equals to 9 by 5 into C plus 32. So, this is the required formula. Now, students, this is your worksheet. Here you have some introduction given. Two kinds of thermometer. A thermometer is used to measure temperature. Two standard units of temperature are the Fahrenheit, that is the degree Fahrenheit, and the Celsius, that is degree Celsius. So water freezes at 0 degree Celsius or 32 degree Fahrenheit and boils at 100 degree Celsius or 212 degree Fahrenheit. The thermometer used by the doctor to measure the temperature of a human body is called the clinical thermometer. So what is clinical thermometer? The thermometer used by a doctor to measure the temperature of a human body. That is the clinical thermometer. The normal temperature of a human body is 37 degree Celsius or 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Now let's work out a few sums of your maths textbook. We are going to do exercise 19. Question number 1. Manish was not feeling well. His mother took his temperature with his thermometer. So, Manish was not feeling well. That is why, what did his mother do? His mother took the help of the thermometer in order to measure his body temperature. So, you can see in the diagram, the thermometer is shown and the graduations or the markings are also represented. So, here you can see the arrow. That means the level of mercury or the reading of the mercury is shown by the arrow. So here the reading of the thermometer is indicated by the arrow over here. That means it is indicating 38.5 degrees Celsius. So you will write his temperature was 38.5 degrees Celsius. Next subpart question, that is subpart B. Why is there a box around the 37 on the scale? So here you can see that a box is there on the 37. So the question is, why is there a box? Children, just now we have studied that 37 degree Celsius is the normal temperature of human body in Celsius scale. So you will write there is a box around the 37 on the scale because it indicates the normal body temperature, right? Next question, why does the scale only go from 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius? You will write this is the range of human body temperature. Okay, this is the range of human body temperature. That means the body temperature of human being cannot fall less than 35 degree Celsius and cannot go above 42 degree Celsius. So this is the standard range of human body temperature. Next, question number 2. So let's see the question. Can you read the temperature on these thermometers? So for reading, what you will do? You will see the red marking where it is up to. See, in the first scale, the red marking is up to 38. So you are going to write 38 degrees Celsius. Done. Next, part B. Here see, we will have to look till where the reading is going. That means where, up till where you can see the colored portion in the inside the thermometer. So you can see the reading at the level 37.7 degrees Celsius. So you will write the answer 37.7 degrees Celsius. Next, subpart C, look up till where you can see the reading. See, you have the colored portion up to 37.5. So you will write 37.5 as the answer. Next, D, you have the reading up to 38.2 degrees Celsius. So in this way, you are going to read the temperatures on the thermometers. Then write the answers. Next, question number 3. Express the following temperatures given in Celsius scale. So here we will have to change the temperature from Celsius scale to Fahrenheit scale. So children, just a few minutes ago, we have learnt how to convert the temperature from Celsius scale to Fahrenheit scale. So the formula is F equals to C into 9 by 5 plus 32. That means you will have to multiply the temperature in degree Celsius with 9 by 5 and then add 32 with it. Then only you will get the temperature in Fahrenheit scale. So here you will have to do a few conversions. First is 30 degree Celsius. So here the temperature in degree Celsius is 30 degree Celsius. So for converting into Fahrenheit scale, what you will do? You will write 30 into 9 by 5 plus 32. Next, you multiply this 30 into 9, that is 270 by 5. Then add 32. So here in this case, by 5 means division. So you are dividing 270 dividing by 5. So what you will get? You will get 54, then add 32 with it. So 54 plus 32, you will get 86 degree Fahrenheit. Alright. Now, next subpart B, 10 degree Celsius. So here the temperature in degree Celsius is 10. So you will write F equals to 10 into 9 by 5 plus 32. Now you multiply this 10 into 9, that is 90 by 5 plus 32. And after that, 90 by 5 means you can do the cancellation and you will get 18. So now 18 plus 32, that is 50 degree Fahrenheit. You are getting the answer. So answer is 50 degree Fahrenheit. Next, subpart C, 40 degree Celsius. So here the temperature in degree Celsius is 40. So you write 40 into 9 by 5 plus 32. Now you are multiplying this 40 with 9 and you are getting 360 by 5 plus 32. Now 360 you divide by 5, you get 72. So you are writing 72 plus 32. And after addition, you are getting the value as 104 degree Fahrenheit. So your answer will be 104 degree Fahrenheit. Next, 100 degree Celsius. So here the temperature in degree Celsius is 100. You will write 100 into 9 by 5 plus 32. Now you multiply 9 into 100. You are multiplying 100 into 9. You will get 900. And after that, divide by 5 plus 32. So 900 after dividing by 5, you will get 180 plus 32. And after addition, you are getting 212 degree Fahrenheit. So students, in this way, you are going to convert the temperatures from degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit using this particular formula. So all of you need to learn up this formula and you do the given sums in your classwork notebook. Thank you all for today.